Good morning, well, I am Rajneesh
here.
I am with the Constitution of the India, and today's the topic is the directive principle of state policy and its importance and its implementations. So we have to discuss by and why. Number one, number two, and the number three. It is well known to us that this subject material, the directive principle of the state policy, it is well set in our constitution, and we have borrowed this from the Irish constitution. It comes well within from the feature of our fundamental rights, and the more important, the real sense, the real purpose of the directive principle of the state policy to minimize the gap in between the social, economical, and the political difference. The first and the foremost and the supreme purpose to improve the DPSP, to simply to minimize the divorce and the gap between the socio-eco-political structure. This is the very important one, because when the framers of the constitution was very much engaged in the drafting the constitution, they took up the points by verifying the priorities, the problem of the Indian constitution, and the put up by and by in the Indian constitution just well within the banner of the fundamental rights. They discussed about the sovereignty, they discussed about the equality, they discussed about the secularism. It has been the well and the clear cut written in a black and white in the fundamental rights, but it cannot be practically achieved without the directive principle of the state policy. You simply confirmed that the widow or the woman empowerment and the old age pension will get India. It has been decided from the floor of the parliament. The center approved it. The approval letter received by the state government in all the states. But a person who is the widow, a person who is the illiterate, a person who is woman but he does not and she does not know the real sense of the empowerment, a farmer who is the well in the grip of the severe flood, there may be other farmer who may be also well in the grip of the severe drought, who will take care of them? The state. It is the directive principle of the state policy. If the state policy only remain, only come in the power and enjoy the power, and he will not take care and he will not engage the deprived one, he will not take care of the widow pension, women empowerment, employment, skill development. It is well known to you, we are the well in the democracy. There is no seat is the final, and the supreme is here. Every seat is allotted for a certain time. You will be the kickback for the upcoming election. So if you want to make your country lapse-free, solid, foremost, potent, effective, there must be the directive principle of the state policy. This policy is also related to states as well as the center. Anshuman Bharat Yojana, it is well operating in all India except Bengal. I am talking about the West Bengal. means the Ayushman Bharat Yojana is not very much accepted by the West Bengal, because the directive principle of the state policy is not biased with the central government. And the people of the local, means the people of the West Bengal, is not getting the due advantage of the our constitutional right they had and they have of the directive principle of the state policy. So it becomes necessary, and the central point for you all the people, you are an engineer, you are the literate one, you must understand the importance of the DPSP. Its article starts from the 36 to 51 article. We will discuss one by one. In the meantime, I am giving one more example to you. In Chhattisgarh election recently, because before you are taking entry into the election, there must be a manifesto. In the manifesto, generally the political pundit and the political framers write down the very big and the very lollipop like things there. And when they come into the power, they simply forget, and they took the 365 turn about their the promises. And at the time of the needed, they will only hovering and the request for the vote and the vote. These all the thing was very much kept in the mind of the Chhattisgarhi people. But at the time of the election, the Congress party, especially, wrote down his promises to the stamp paper and gave these all to their voters. If I will do it, thing is all right. If I will not do it, this is my stamp paper. And this happened in the Chhattisgarh. What is this? You cannot make your public fool. You can make your public fool one time, two times, thrice time, but not always. And this thing happened. Well, in the Chhattisgarh election. Very simple. The development of your nation, the strength of your constitution, it cannot be perceived without very strengthful, very positive effect of the directive principle of the state policy. And that starts from the 36 to 51. We'll discuss later on. So it becomes a very important for a student to go through this all the study. And if the preamble, in our preamble, constitutional preamble, there has been the written a very big and a very affecting thing, it is not happening properly, you can go even for the court under the accordance with the directive principle of the state policy. So this is a very powerful tools the constitution has given. If the state government is not taking care, you can shake hand with the court, and the court will take care of these all the things. And it happens in generally in our different faculty. In the meantime, I am closing this topic. I discussed today about the directive principle of the state policy. Generally, we have taken from the Irish constitution this state policy article and the legalized 36 to 51, and the importance of directive principle of the state policy. I discuss about these things, the legal implications and the legal implementation we will discuss in our next class. In the meantime, one thing be sure for you all the students, that the ratio and the effectiveness of the strengthness of the DPSP will directly proportional to the growth of your democracy. In the meantime, I am taking goodbye. Thank you very much.